All right, so we're here with Black Maze and the crew of Rebuy Unlimited. Black Maze, we're about to premiere this video of the newest offering of your crew. Why don't you tell us a little bit about it to intro it up?
Totally. And first of all, again, thanks for having me, as always. Rebuy Unlimited is pretty much a comedic web series that we've started for the Elite Dangerous Odyssey when it released. And people are about to watch the second episode of the season one. It's not really a full episode, but more we're kind of releasing snippet episodes, short episodes, while we're still waiting for some livery fixes and opaque visors to start working. So we're kind of using this time to introduce our characters through some short episodes.
Right on. So basically, red versus blue, but funnier, faster, leaderer, and dangerouser.
The pressure is on.
Yeah. All right, well, let's enjoy the clip.
4, 3, 2, 1, engage.
Osiris Hagen requesting landing for prison. Requesting landing for detainee laborer transfer.
Access permitted. Set down on landing pad 1-6.
Of course, it had to be today, didn't it? Just my luck.
Vail, get your gear and let's go. You've got a job to do.
That you, Hagen? What is it this time? Does Grace want the odd tuned up again?
Just move it.
You know, I was wondering why I was getting transferred out of here today. It's film night, you know. So what's new with you? Kill anyone interesting recently?
We have places to be, Dan. Suit up.
Yeah, I'm coming.
You know, I'm gonna miss some of the folks in here. Some fun characters. Smasher Lee, the Big Yin, the Butcher of Thanatos.
Oh yeah? What are they in for?
Fun story. Type 9 cargo blowout. 700 units of meat. Whole station stinks. They're still finding chunks of it in the ammo recyclers.
What the hell, Dan? You couldn't wait to get on board the dropship?
I have been holding it in for hours. These buggers hardly ever let you out, and this is the only toilet on the deck.
Fine. Just hurry up. Well, aren't you gonna wash up?
Get over yourself, Hagen.
Right, that's 65 slaves offloaded. Same rate as usual.
I think you mean 65 detainee laborers?
Right.
Anyway.
What is it?
I just remembered. I was gonna break out today.
You talk some real nonsense, McPhail. And just how were you gonna break out?
Classic. Gonna Trojan horse myself on board the resupply ship.
You thought you were gonna sneak out in empty cargo containers? You know they inspect those, right?
Not the sewage containers, they don't.
Good stuff, man. That is a funny video, and remind me not to shake that dude's hand. All right, so let's start with Osashis. As the screenwriter, how do you come up with these stories?
So I actually got dragged into this by Black Maze. I'm a longtime writer to do stuff for like Sagittarius Eye. This is actually my first stint at screenwriting, so this is definitely a team effort. The entire team comes up with great ideas and stuff, and then we just kind of work together to expand on those and try to find ways to make them a little more funny and interesting.
Right on, right on. Yeah, you've done a lot as one of the in-house writers of SAG-AI to help sort of promote and sort of put a big spotlight on the race community, and so big salute to you for that. So Dan, let me ask, how are you finding Odyssey as far as a platform to create these films? What does it get right? What would you love to see added? How does it fill your needs?
I mean, you could go on quite a long time about the various issues, and that's why we switched to this sort of shorter form format in the first term. We've got really good first episode script we haven't used yet, but what I think is great about it, what gives us, first of all, it's the human thing, right? I know people have tried in the past to get, you know, things like this Macamania stuff done in Elite, and it's been ships. It doesn't, you can't quite connect with the ship the same way as you can. We can actually see a person. So that's a big plus. And the other thing that really stands out is the bases and the settlement areas. It's obvious that there's a lot of love and a lot of effort put into them and how they work. So there's lots of really cool potential spots and corners and angles and things to shoot that look really good. So I'm dead keen to get more into that and find the right locations and get them shot.
And how are you finding sort of the transition from the, let's say, teaser trailer that was pre-Odyssey, where it was all filmed in ships, to this first mini episode that is, okay, you're actually now walking around and whatnot, which was easier for you to actually lay out and do?
I think it's more intuitive to define sort of shots and acting from a human point of view, if that makes sense. Trying to get characters obvious when it's a bunch of ships talking to each other isn't quite as clear. But the control input thing's interesting. It was definitely easier to sort of fly a ship that I've had plenty of practice of flying rather than trying to get the walking around acting stuff done right. That's definitely a different problem set to have to try and solve.
And I noticed
the same in real life.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Once you have people in real life, it's easier to sort of to attribute those emotions and whatnot. And I want to call you out on something, Dan, that you failed to do. You failed to get the authentic Odyssey greeting of when two people come across each other, they both kneel and stand and kneel and stand and kneel and stand. Maybe you can work that into the next one?
I don't know. I feel like that's, again, partially a limitation, partially an evolution type thing. As you've seen in the clip, it kind of works without it, I think. But
It's kind of sad, isn't it? Like, the whole Elite Dangerous, the concept around the 07, like, how the hell did they not lean into that? Why do we not have animations that we can, like, emotes that we can trigger? How can you have Elite Dangerous where everybody greets each other with 07? And then you get on foot, and all you have is the tea bag.
Well, that's something to look forward to. Yeah, yeah. Now, my next question I want to address to Alex, A-L-E-X Turner of the Buckyball Racer, who as we all know, the Buckyball Racers are responsible for all things racing, including Rebuy Unlimited and all of the Scarab Mastery Challenge. Yes, yes. This is ours now. That's the American version. Oh, actually, you guys did it first, the British version of you show up and plant a flag and say, this is ours now. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
So how many characters do you guys sort of have, and what's sort of the backstory of these guys? How is the, you know, how did they sort of evolve into the characters that we're seeing as part of the Rebuy crew now?
Yeah, interesting. I mean, there are a whole bunch of characters. Black Maze will probably correct me, but there's like 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, I think, maybe. Probably got that number wrong. But they came about pretty organically, I think. Sash's, you know, as writers sort of came up with a bunch, but we've had a bunch of brainstorming sessions where we've kind of worked out the differences between the characters, and we've worked out kind of looks and costumes and things. Viewers kind of don't really know the characters yet, I think. I think these little teasers will give them a bit of an insight, but they do each have a backstory. I don't think I should kind of reveal that yet. I think the story will do that, hopefully.
So what I'm hearing is there's definitely still room to include a character, say, a media mogul who could be like a bad guy or like just a bumbling idiot that's constantly getting involved in maybe.
No, got the bumbling idiot. That's right, Ty, isn't it?
Wow.
You can always have more bumbling idiots.
Shots fired. Wow.
As you might already know, me and Ty already have a little bit of rivalry going on in this.
Right. Well, clearly. I mean, as it's a Buckyball Racers event, you have to try to lay down the law. I got you. All right, Eliza, can you share something about your character? You're the sort of the goddess amongst all of this sausage. Tell us a little bit about you.
I play Eliza Fenador. She's the daughter of Dalton Fenador, and he's the owner of Rebuy Unlimited, and she's been sent to do some work with the Rebuy team because she's obviously quite a spoiled brat. So he's been put into her place a little bit. She's not very happy about it.
I noticed in the sort of teaser trailer that you guys did before Odyssey dropped, where you were all in the ships, there was a little bit of chatter back and forth, and it kind of had that kind of feel of like, oh, I don't know, like from The Office or whatever, some of these great stories where there's somebody that's in charge, nominally at least, but maybe they get a little bit of razzing or whatever from the actual crew.
Yeah, I think she's got her work cut out for her, because I don't think she is in charge at all, even though her dad is the owner of Rebuy Unlimited. I think she's going to get walked over quite a bit, but we'll have to wait and see what kind of stories Sasha's comes up with.
Right on. So Black Maze, as these stories progress and as the episodes go on, you know, I mean, obviously, all kidding aside on the Buckyball race thing, you know, you're a big part of the Elite Racer community, and you've got people in this group that are from the Elite Racers, from, you know, Buckyballers, all these different groups. And I feel like this is a very cool bringing together of the race community to sort of do something, you know, silly and fun and whatever. And I feel like right now, not to focus on negativity or whatever, but there's sort of a lot of feelings being expressed in the Elite Dangerous community. And I think that something like this project and the stuff that, you know, some other Machinima creators do, where it's like, okay, I can just put on a video, it's going to go for 5 minutes, I can laugh and be silly and whatever. I think it's very timely and very, very needed.
Amen to that.
Yeah. So tell us a little bit of where you see this going and sort of what sparked the original concept of like, hey, we're going to get together as a group and do this.
So that's an awesome question. And I couldn't agree with you more. We really do need some refreshing positivity, right? Absolutely. This thing, I've attempted something like this before. And as Donald 47, who plays Dan, just mentioned, it's always been quite limiting with only ships and maybe people in SRVs, but it's very limiting in what you can do. And as soon as we knew that Odyssey was releasing and we were going to get on foot gameplay like that, I was like, this is the chance. This is the moment that this needs to happen again. Obviously massively inspired by Red versus Blue. I wanted to set out and do something like that again. But truth be told, I'm not all that funny and I'm not a good writer at all, especially with English being my secondary language. I need a lot of help there. And I started thinking, you know, if this is to work, we need a crew. We need to have a good set of people with a variety in talent. And here we have now screenwriters, voice actors, people doing graphics. We've got so many different nationalities. We have English, American, Australian accents. It's going to be such an incredible combination of talent coming together to put this to life. And we're learning because this is new for all of us. So, you know, between the pilot and these little short episodes that we're releasing now, there's so much to learn for us in the process with recording and editing and all that. But we're getting it down. And as soon as the final touches are done to Odyssey, to answer your question, where is this going to go? I think this has so, so much potential. And the thing I am the most excited for about Odyssey right now is Rebuy Unlimited. I just can't wait.
Yeah, man. Setting aside issues and whatever that people have with Odyssey, if you just look at it from the standpoint of, okay, like, let's not look at it and what's there and what's missing, but just look at it from the standpoint of what has happened with the scope and what can we do with this going forward. The addition of having the ability to, you know, have this whole other way of experiencing the galaxy does open up so many possibilities. You know, we said, hey, the emotes aren't quite there yet, but they have acknowledged on stream Frontier that, you know, yeah, we've heard you and we're looking into that. Obviously, they got some fires to deal with right now before they, I think it's like number step one, that building's on fire, put it out. Step two, now let's bake some cookies. And I think emotes and there's some other good stuff that come as the cookies. And I look forward very much to seeing Frontier implementing some of these cookies after, you know, give them 2-3 months to get the fire sorted. And then seeing what people like you or, you know, Terjan Starstone or Scorbius or Spatula or just other player groups, other people do with this. I'm looking forward to seeing, you know, how it gets planned out. And let me just ask you now, I'm going to put you on the spot for a Elite Week exclusive. Go ahead and give us one spoiler of something that's to come. And I'm saying this knowing that you guys are like, hell, we haven't even written this shit yet. But now I'm going to force you to say something, and then you're going to have to write it into one of the episodes later in the season of something. So think of something completely nonsensical and give us a spoiler of what's to come. I'm going to go around the room and ask everybody. All right, Black Maze, one spoiler, go.
Organ transplants go all horribly
right.
wrong.
All right, Alex Freeman, go.
Cobra Mark 3, Rattler Orange for the win.
All right. Dan, go.
AI Barrett Mason into the wrong computer.
Eliza. What the fuck? Eliza, go.
I don't have anything.
How about a spicy love scene between you and Black Maze, huh?
A common love scene. So Barrett Mason is an AI. He has no body. Where does that go?
Hey, don't kink shame her. You let her express herself as she wants.
There are technical solutions to this problem.
People that have played Mass Effect will know what's up.
Mm-hmm. All right. So Eliza.
Robot love scenes.
Robot love scenes. Confirmed. And lastly, the writer, the main man, Osashis.
I'll give you two, actually.
Okay.
So more toilet shots.
Mm-hmm.
And to go on, you know, actually what's going to happen, there will be a legitimate love roller coaster, but you'll see who and what and where in the future.
Any chance that you can get sort of a walk-on cameo from a media mogul to be part of the love roller coaster? I'm just saying, if I get to make out with Alex Freeman, it would be like off the bucket list.
Wow.
Just one thing marked off.
You might get to make out with the tailpipe of a cobra, but you know, we'll make something.
I'm worried about this love scene now. Is there any coincidence why Ty and Alex have rooms next to each other?
Oh, no.
I just wanted to say, so we have our Rebuy Unlimited headquarters sorted, right? We went through all the settlements and we found one that we liked that we called home. I'm not going to spoil yet where or how or when it is, but we did look at all the rooms and every crew member has their designated room. It's pretty cute.
Nice. Very nice. All right. Yeah. Well, guys, it's been awesome getting to talk to you and getting to premiere the world premiere of this video for the Elite Week audience. Thank you very, very much. And I look forward to more to come. Make sure you let us know when the next one's ready.
Don't fly with that rebuy.
Yep. 07.